Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya ala s-salah. Hayya ala s-salah. Hayya ala al-falah. Hayya ala al-falah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah.
Alhamdulillah, 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 thumma alhamdulillah. Wa ma tawfiqi wa la i'tisami illa billah. Alayhi tawakkaltu wa ilayhi unib. Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa natubu ilayhi. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdi illahu fala mudilla lah. ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله أما بعد فيا عباد الله أحبكم في الله وأوصيكم ونفسي بالتقوى الله وطاعته إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. My dear brothers and sisters, today inshallah we're going to be talking about one of the important subjects, the ways that leads us to the paradise. What kind of road, which road we should follow in order to enter Jannah. The first thing, in order to enter Jannah, we should have iman. Iman is the most important cause, the leading to paradise by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can hardly find a place in which faith and iman, faith means iman, mentioned as a cause of entering paradise, except that it will be accompanied with the performance of good deeds, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always, when you see إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Always, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned iman, He says إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, or إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Which is, when we look Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah 82, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم,
والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أولئك أصحاب الجنة أولئك أصحاب الجنة هم فيها خالدون.
And those who believe and do righteous deeds, they are dwellers of paradise. They are the people that they're gonna enter to the Jannah, inshallah. And they will be therein forever, which is they will stay there forever in the Jannah. Amanu wa amilu salihat. Which is, my dear brothers and sisters, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says amanu wa amilu salihat? Iman is not enough, my dear brothers and sisters, in order to enter Jannah. We should, iman has to be with a'mal as-salihah, with good deeds. To believe only is not enough. You have to prove your belief with your good deeds. We have to show in our life that we are a mu'min. We have to implement in our life. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Amenu wa amilu salihati. Those who believe and do righteous deeds. It's not only believe. Believe and they do righteous deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 25, He said,
وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ أَنَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayah, and gave glad tidings, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to those who believe and do righteous deeds and do good deeds, that they will have gardens in paradise beneath which rivers flow. When you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Jannatun tajri min tahti al anhar, did you imagine? Did you think about only just for a second what that means? Jannatun tajri min tahti al anhar. You're gonna be walking on the surface, but you're gonna see underneath rivers flows. That you're gonna be walking on plain glass, kind of the glass that you can see underneath the field, the river flows everywhere. That's what Jannatun tajri min tahti al anhar. Did you see in any movies the view like that? It is impossible view. But in the Jannah, impossible is possible. You can see Jannatun tajri min tahti al anhar. You're gonna be walking on the surface and you're gonna see the river, all kind of the river underneath, beneath of you. That is the Jannah. That is the Jannah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes impossible possible. The things in the dunya that you think it is impossible, but will be possible there. You ask fruit, you ask anything, it will be in your hand. They will serve you. Anything you ask. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among the people of the Jannah, inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Luqman, ayah 8,
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ النَّعِيمِ.
Verily those who believe and do righteous deeds, for them are gardens of paradise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Kahf, ayah 107,
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ كَانَتْ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ نُزُلًا.
Verily those who believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do righteous deeds, they will have the gardens of Al-Firdaus for their entertainment. Which is Firdaus, as you see, is in the Quran in two places. One place in Surah Al-Kahf, and the other one, the beginning of Surah Al-Mu'minun. This is the highest rank in the Jannah, the highest level in the Jannah. How many levels is in the Jannah? It's 100 levels. There will be 100 levels in the Jannah. And we cannot imagine like the levels in the dunya. But according to their deeds, people, they're going to get their rewards. You think the person that he doesn't have that much a'mal, but he entered paradise, him and Abu Bakr Siddiq will be the same level? It cannot. Because his a'mal and Abu Bakr a'mal is indifferent. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he gave everything what he owned for the Islam and Muslims. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told him, what you have left for your children when he brought for the Ghazwa to Tabuk, his aim, he said, I have left them Allah and his Prophet. When he asked Umar, he said, radiallahu anhu, he said, half of my this wealth. And from that moment, Umar said, not me, nobody can race with Abu Bakr with this matter. You think it will be in the same level with Abu Bakr? It is impossible. That's why people, they're going to get their level, their reward according to their good deeds. There will be so many houses. Some houses made it from different stones. Some houses from gold, some houses from diamond. See, small diamond is how much? But the house is built with the diamond. Houses will build with the gold. With so many other kind of the precious stones. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hajj, ayah 14, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
إن الله يدخل الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار إن الله يفعل ما يريد.
As for those who believe and do righteous deeds, Allah will admit them to gardens underneath which rivers flow. And Allah indeed does what He wills. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does what He wants, what He wills. The third thing you said, we said the first thing in order to enter paradise was the iman and good deeds. The third one is the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Taqwa linguistically means to protect or to shield, as a protect oneself from wrongdoing. From the Arabic word waqa, which is waf, qaf, qaf and ya, which means to preserve something, to take good of something, to be cautious, to protect, to prevent, to preserve a thing against any harm or injury. But taqwa in Sharia means refers to consciousness of Allah. It describes as a state of awareness of Allah in everything we do, and letting that awareness guide our actions and shield us from harm. Ittaqullah means, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, means take Allah as your protector, or it could be mean guard yourself against consequences of violating Allah's command by obeying Him. And Prophet ﷺ, he said, At-taqwa dhirwatu sanamul Islam. Is taqwa is the top of the level of Islam. Which is, we have Islam, Iman, Ihsan, and taqwa. Which is the taqwa dhirwat sanamul Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when we said actually is fearing Allah, the Exalted. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hijr, ayah 45,
إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونٍ.
Indeed, the righteous will be within gardens and springs. In fact, paradise is prepared for those who have taqwa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al Imran, ayah 133,
وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَّبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ.
And be quick in the race for forgiveness from your Lord and for paradise as wide as the heavens and the earth, prepared for muttaqin.
قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أكثر ما يدخل الجنة تقوى الله وحسن الخلق وأكثر ما يدخل النار ما يدخل الناس النار الفم والفرج.
رواه الترمذي ابن ماجه وأحمد. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, the things which most warrant entrance into paradise are taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and husnul khuluq, means good behavior, good akhlaq. These two things, most of the people, they're going to enter to the Jannah with these two things: taqwa Allah and husnul khuluq, good akhlaq.
If you have bad akhlaq, then you have to try to change your akhlaq into good akhlaq. If you are treating people bad, then you have to start trying people nice. You have to have good akhlaq, good treatment toward people. Treat people as you want to be treated. Believe me, brothers, if you treat people as you want to be treated, then you will not have any mistake. Do you want people, when they talk to you with harshness, with loud voice? Of course not. Then don't talk to them the same way. Change your akhlaq into good akhlaq. If you want to enter paradise, then you should have a good akhlaq. The paradise is the place for good people. The people that they have good akhlaq, good behavior. And the Prophet ﷺ said, and the things which most warrant entrance into hellfire, what is that? Is the mouth and private parts. These two things. That's why Prophet ﷺ, what he said in the hadith, he said, من ضمن لي ما بين لحييه ورجليه ضمنت له على الله الجنة. He said, whoever gave me warranty from these two things, I will give him warranty that that person will enter Jannah. What is that? ما بين لحييه, which is between two lips. What is that? It is the tongue. It's tongue. And the second one is between two legs, which is private parts. If you control this too, I will give you warranty you will enter Jannah. That's why Prophet ﷺ said, if you control this too, your tongue and your private parts, you will enter Jannah. Prophet ﷺ is Jawami'ul Kalim. When he talks very short, but means a lot. Give me warranty from this too. Protect your tongue from anything bad. Any badness or anything to pronounce bad, protect your tongue. Means what? You cannot commit ghiba, backbiting. Backbiting is done by what? It's tongue. What is that? They say the tongue doesn't have any bones. You can turn him any way you want. But the tongues could be causing for you to enter hellfire. And private parts. Private parts is very important things, my dear brothers and sisters. Protecting ourselves is very difficult, especially in this country and all over the world, especially in this the age of the internet. The age of the facade, it's very difficult. How you can protect your children? Protect your children when they reach in the age of the marriage, immediately do not be burden for them, do not be barrier for them. If they want to get married, doesn't matter even they are 18, 19, 16, 17, 20. If they want to get married, let them marry. Have a big heart for them. Another plate in your dinner or in your sofra, in your place. Protect your children. Protect yourself. If you protect these two, according to the Prophet ﷺ, you will enter Jannah, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us one of them, inshallah. And the fourth thing is obeying Allah and His Messenger. The fourth way that will enter paradise will be the obeying Allah and His Messenger, Prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says,
وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ يُدْخِلْهُ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ومن يتولى يعذبه عذابا أليما.
This ayah was from Surah Al-Fath, ayah 17. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger, He will admit him to garden beneath river which river flows. And but whoever turns away, He will punish him with a painful punishment. He will punish him with a painful punishment. In Sahih Bukhari, it is reported that from Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, the Messenger of Allah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Kullu ummati yadkhuluna al-jannah illa man aba." He said, "Every one of my nation, my ummah, will enter paradise, save those who refuse, except those who refuse." And the companions, they said, "O Messenger of Allah, who refuses? You know, the Jannah is a good place to enter. Who refuses to enter?" And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Man ata'ani dakhala al-jannah wa man asani faqad aba." He said, "Whoever obeys me shall enter paradise, Jannah, and whoever disobeys me has refused to enter to the Jannah." Means, if you do not obey and Allah's Messenger, you cannot enter to the Jannah. Which is, lately you see some people that they say, "Oh, we accept only Quran, we do not accept anything else. We don't accept Sunnah, we don't accept this. We accept only Quran, Allah's book." When you tell them, "Brother, really you accept?" "Yeah, I accept everything." Then what you gonna say about the ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
"قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ."
What you gonna say about this ayah? Tell them, "O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي." Tell them, "If you really love me, then follow me. If you really, you are saying that you are loving me, then follow me. You are loving Allah, then you have to follow Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. If you do that, if you follow Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ, He will love you. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ, and He will enter you to the paradise. Means, what you gonna say, brother? What you gonna say about وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى? What you gonna say, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَى أَحَدٍ مِنْ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. So many other ayat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want us to follow His own messenger. The messengers, they are the guide to the paradise. If you don't have messenger, that you cannot find the way. You cannot find the way. In order to find the way, you should have the messengers. That's why prophets, and especially Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen him among us in order to show us the right way, the right path. The path that leading us to the paradise. And the next one, my dear brothers and sisters, the fifth one is repentance. Repentance. Repentance wipes away the evil actions. Wipes away evil actions that preceded. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "At-ta'ibu min al-dhanbi kaman la dhanba lah." The repentant from a sin is like one who does not have a sin, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase your sin when you repent. "At-ta'ibu min al-dhanbi kaman la dhanba lah." That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create us. Of course, naturally, all of us, we are making sin. All of us, please, brothers, can we turn off our cell phones? Turn off your cell phones, inshallah. While the cell phones is on, please do not enter to the masjid because it's really bothering us. And do not go out to answer your phones because you are right now in state of the worship. Some people, I see them, they go out to answer the phones. Do not answer those phones. When you enter here, can you leave your salah and go answer phone and come back, keep continue your salah? You cannot. The same as the Jum'ah prayer. You cannot answer your phones. When you answer your phones, your Jum'ah is gone. I'm sorry to say, but your Jum'ah is gone. Don't be smart, try to answer your calls or go out to answer your calls. Your Jum'ah is gone. I just reminding everybody, inshallah. التائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. The person, when he repents, he will not have any sin left, inshallah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Maryam, ayah 60,
إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا فأولئك يدخلون الجنة ولا يظلمون شيئا.
Except those who repented and believed and worked righteousness, for those will enter paradise and they will not be wronged at all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us because we are not like angels. Angels, they do not have choice, do bad or right. But human, they only what they do, يَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded them, they have to do it. That's their job. Remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all time, and they cannot disobey the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command. But human is not like that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us, when we make any mistake, immediately we return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, I have done this, forgive me. إِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. When my servant asks about me, I am very near to him. He doesn't have to put the people between me and him. You do not have to go and say, oh, Sheikh so-and-so, please ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive me. I remember one of the guy, he came to one of the Sheikh and he told him, brother, please, you are good person. You know, you are knowledgeable. And please, I have done so many mistakes in my life, in my past. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive me. And he told him, brother, if I tell you what I have done in my past, you will spit on my face. Don't think that I am a very good person. But we all humans, we all make mistakes. But whenever we make mistakes, we should turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is ghafoor and rahim. He is ghafoor and rahim. He's most merciful, most beneficent. That's why he said, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I start with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most beneficent, the most merciful. We say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. And do not be hopeless from Allah's mercy. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says,
قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ.
Tell them, O Muhammad, whoever transgressed on their deeds, which they did zulm themselves by doing so many mistakes in their life, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Do not be hopeless from Allah's mercy. Because one of the great sin, just reminding everybody, one of the great sin is when you think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive you. When you despair from Allah's mercy. When you cut your hope from the forgiveness, and that is big, big mistake, when one of the major sin, it's like a zina, like one of the major sins in Islam, is to be hopeless from Allah's mercy. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Verily Allah will forgive all your sins. He's غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. He will forgive all your sins. Don't be hopeless. You don't have to put the people between you and Allah. Allah is very near to you. The best time for the forgiveness, my dear brother, for the tawbah, wake up for the Salat al-Tahajjud, which is the best time. Last part is 3 o'clock. And pray, make your wudu while everybody is sleeping here. Make your wudu and pray 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, whatever you want. And later on, open your hand. Say, oh Allah, I have done this and this. Forgive me. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. Nobody will forgive except you. And cry for your sins. And inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins. Only one sins, which is, if you took people's right and you ask Allah's forgiveness, He will not forgive you. If you did some wrongdoing to someone, take his mal, wealth, or something else, you did zulm to him or her, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive you for that. Because that is people's right. He will forgive anything related to Him. If you didn't fast enough, if you didn't pray enough, if you didn't give your zakat enough, so many other things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. But He will not forgive people's right. That's why be very careful people's right. Always I remind everybody, myself and everybody, please, if anybody has a right on you, before you die, go and ask forgiveness from them. Because you have chance now. When it's your last breath, you cannot. And nobody knows when will be his time. When his time will be up, nobody knows. Any time, any moment, any second could happen, could come. That's why we should, inshallah, try to be ready for that. The one of the most important things that always ask people who have right on you, please forgive me. I have done such and such, please forgive me. Or if you get their money, return their money. Return their haq, they could return their right and ask forgiveness from them. And of course, they have heart, they will forgive you. But in the akhirah, nobody will forgive you, my dear brothers and sisters. Nobody will give you good deeds. Nobody will give you, because over there, everybody needs. But marhama here in the dunya, in the akhirah, nobody will have mercy on you. That's why ask forgiveness before we go, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among the people that they are trying to follow Prophet as much as they can, inshallah. The time is not enough, inshallah. We're going to stop here, but did not finish the subject there. The ways that leading us to the paradise, inshallah, will continue next khutbah, inshallah. Alayna ahsan kalam wablagh nizam. Kalam Allah al-Malik al-Aziz al-Alam. Kama qala Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala fil kalam. Wa idha quri al-Qur'an fastami'u lah. Wa ansitu la'allakum turhamun. Ya ibn Adam, ahbib ma shita fa innaka mufariqu. Wa amal ma shita fa innaka mulaqi. Wa kun kama shita fa kama tadinu tudan. Inna الدين عند الله الإسلام. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ورسولنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن سلك وتبع طريقهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن شرف صفيه، فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم ارض عن الأربعة الخلفاء أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي الصدق والوفاء، وعن البقية العشرة المبشرة وأهل البيت المصطفى. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين. اللهم أيد كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من كيد الشيطان، ونعوذ بك من الكبر والكذب والرياء والغيبة والشقاق والنفاق وسوء الأخلاق. اللهم باعد بيننا وبين الشيطان كما بعدت بين المشرق والمغرب. اللهم تبنا فتب علينا، اللهم تبنا فتب علينا، اللهم تبنا فتب علينا، اللهم كلنا ولا تكن علينا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم لا تخرجنا من الدنيا إلا مع الشهادة والإيمان. اللهم وجهنا لكل عمل يرضيك عنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر إخوان الذين يجاهدون في سبيلك في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها. اللهم ساعدهم وثبت أقدامهم وانصرهم على عدوهم، إنك إذا قلت لشيء كن فيكون يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر إخواننا في سوريا يا رب، إنك على كل شيء قدير، وإنك إذا قلت لشيء كن فيكون يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر أموات المسلمين الذين شهدوا لك بالوحدانية ولرسولك بالرسالة. اللهم اشف مرضى المسلمين، إنك أنت الشافي والكافي يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. آمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
استووا اعتدلوا. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله، إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا، إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. وأنيبوا إلى ربكم وأسلموا له من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب ثم لا تنصرون. واتبعوا أحسن ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب بغتة وأنتم لا تشعرون. أن تقول نفس يا حسرة على ما فرطت في جنب الله وإن كنت لمن الساخرين. أو تقول لو أن الله هداني لكنت من المتقين. أو تقول حين ترى العذاب لو أن لي كرة فأكون من المحسنين. بلى قد جاءتك آياتي فكذبت بها واستكبرت وكنت من الكافرين. الله أكبر.
سمي الله لمن حمده
الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فاجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله